Hello, my name is Randall Weil from FuelAlternative.info. This is my sand filter project. There are multiple reasons why one would be interested in a biosand filter for third world countries where people have no real clean water, let alone uncontaminated and even sanitized water to drink. Not to mention hurricanes, floods, natural disasters of myriad different kinds, whether it be power outages, earthquakes, or even tornadoes. No one knows when or where things will happen, and it's best to be prepared, as the old Boy Scout motto would say. All you can do is be prepared to the best of your ability and plan ahead in case the event of a disaster. Not to mention third world country application. There's a lot of resources to find biosand filters, but many of them prefer to get donations, get you money. Whatever the reason, it's been kind of challenging to find specific details on how to construct a biosand filter. These are some of the things that I found in my search. The best one that I have found has been right up here, the CAWST.org. And if I highlight up here, let's see if I can highlight that. I would go to that website. It's a PDF that you can download and save and go through step by step the specifics, the measurements, and how to, and many of the things that it can do and possible filter out in worst case scenario. And God, I hope, please, that this is not the worst case scenario. EMP could be one of the things that could happen, and we'd only pray that our people, our military, our country is being protected by men and brave women against this possible threat, not to mention solar flares or some terrorists state-sponsored somewhere, doing something that would harm our system, take down the grid, and without electricity, an EMP can do a lot of havoc and damage. Again, it's best to be prepared and be wise, and do your best to be a good citizen to help others and your neighbors. So let's get started. Here, I want you to take a time, look at the materials list here, and even pause and do a screen capture, paste it in your, possibly, it's over here. I don't have that up on the screen, but anyways, you want to go and use a screen capture, print this onto your Windows Paint or in a document, and print it out so you can take it with you to the store. Or you can use whatever's laying around, happen to be in surplus, and available at your hands. Here's a few examples. You can use one here that looks like it was a takeoff from a garbage can. There's others who use a 50-gallon barrel. Or you can construct something with concrete, like Samaritan Purse Outreach Ministries have done. But whatever the resource and material that you have, it is still the same basic construction. Choose the means and the materials, whether it be a small container, a wide container. The wider, the better the flow of water. You're going to have a lid, diffuser, filtration, which is your sand in this area. You're going to have the outlet tube, whether it be in the material or inside the tube, which what I'll be doing. You have separation gravel, which is your quarter inch, and then you have your drainage gravel here, which is going to be at the bottom where the tube inlet will be, which is half inch gravel. Here I'm using a 36 inch long cut tube of 4 inch PVC. I measure 6 inches from the top. That's where I will be cutting or drilling a hole, excuse me. On the bottom, we're using a flange, a toilet flange, to mount, which normally mounts toilets, and we're going to use that with the plug still intact, sealed, and glued into the bottom to use as a stand. Be sure to have it seated completely. This is when we're going to drill our hole where the spout will be coming out from the inside out and drain into your bucket for fresh clean water after the filtration. Drill a pilot hole with a small drill bit. Next we'll be grabbing a 5/8 drill bit. The 5/8 drill bit is what about the size of the outer diameter of the CPVC that's a 1/2 inch. Next we're going to mark and cut 1-inch pieces, two of them, for our T fitting for the bottom of the filter. All these fittings that we're using are going to be 1/2 inch CPVC cuttings and fittings for the internal hardware or plumbing of this filter. And for the spout, we're going to be using 1 1/4 inch, like what we just cut here, that will be going from the inside to the outside of the filter housing. Make sure they're well glued. We don't want any seepage or holes or areas where no glue has gotten to. The 1 inch are fitted into the T and in slight twist. That way we have everything set up just right. Here we want to make sure we get these pieces and fittings put together first and foremost, and I'll show you the reason why later, because we need to fine adjust or cut to the right length from the bottom of the inner tube to the top where it comes out for the spout hole. Meanwhile, we're going to take our 1 1/4 piece and glue it to one of the 90 degree elbows, because this will be coming through the hole, the 5/8 hole that we drilled in the casing of the 4-inch PVC. We'll attach it to the elbow, and then that elbow will be attached to the top of the longer piece, which is about 2.5 feet long, which is on the right of the screen. Here we're going to measure it as it's sitting on the outside. We want to line it up and mark where the hole comes out at the bottom. Let's zoom back up. See that hole right there where the 6-inch arrow is? We want to cut and mark at the top of that half inch CPVC and cut there, because that's where the elbow will be coming in contact with the top on the inside of this tube. We want to make sure we have holes which are 5/16 holes, and we're taking a little bit of this sock that you can find at Lowe's in the water drainage and plumbing department. We're going to wrap it around and twist it on the top and bottom, and using twist wire stainless steel to secure it. The idea is to keep most of the pebbles and some of the sediment out of the tube. I'm doing this as an extra advantage or benefit. If you construct a tube sand filter properly, you wouldn't need the sand filter to have a sock or a sediment filter like what I'm doing here. It's just an added bonus. Of course, one can always use a knee-high stocking or a nylon from a lady's worn-out nylon that one of the women may or may not have, but there's always options. Here we're going to go ahead and glue the spout tube to one of the 90 degree elbows, as well as what they call a joining collar or a coupling collar. That coupling collar will be on one end and the 90 degree at the other, the 4-inch long 1/2 inch CPVC tube. When we're done, it'll look much like this. Now we're going to put this tube with this elbow and the 1 1/4 inch well glued, and we're going to insert it inside the 4-inch PVC tube. Make sure it seats down and push it right on through. The glue will be glued saturated on the inside to fill in any gaps or water leakage areas. Then we're going to go ahead and get some glue and pretty well goo up the outside of that perimeter on the outside. This is where the coupling collar, the 1/2 inch, will come in contact, and with the glue being squeezed in, should fill in all the gaps. We will wipe up the excess with a rag when we're done. Give a slight twist so to distribute the glue evenly inside the tube. At one point, we're going to go ahead and wash, whether with a garden hose, fresh source, or clean source. It doesn't have to be sanitized. It may or may not have pathogens. As long as it's filtered relatively decent, clean water. Add the water, swish it around by hand. At this point, I have a garden hose, which is a privilege. And rinse, swishing the sand around, the 1/4 inch and the 1/2 inch, as well as the coarse sand, until it's almost clean. You're not going to have it perfect, but you will have a slight murkiness when it's nice and decent to work with. When you first start out, it could be pretty ugly and murky, and you'll wonder why you're doing this. At this point, we're going to go ahead and fill with the 1/2 inch gravel. Here I'm using 1/2 inch round rock. It's preferred that you have 1/2 inch consistent. It'll cover the bottom of the filter plumbing tube, which is the CPVC, the 1/2 inch, and the T that we have wrapped with a sock. In some cases, you won't have a filter sock or that added benefit that I'm using here. This is the whole reason why the 1/2 inch rock is there, for helping with drainage and filtering out some of the finer particles so they don't end up jamming up inside the tube. Once we get at least a couple centimeters, and you can refer back to your booklet or your PDF that you downloaded previously from the CAST organization, we will go ahead and add in the 1/4 inch after that, making sure it's even across the top. It'll be equivalent about to 3 inches in most cases. Here I use a lot more because the sand, the 1/4 inch sand I'm using, or gravel, is actually mixed. They call it 1/4 minus. And because it's got 1/4 inch and smaller particles, it's virtually a sand of a very coarse nature anyways. It still works. It would be better if I had a consistent 1/4 inch rather than multiple things smaller than 1/4 inch mixed, but still very heavy, coarse sand and consistent with the concept. Here we're going to continue with construction of the diffuser. We'll do this after we completed the filling of the container or the tube, the sand, as we did in the PDF. Here I'm outlining on the inside with a black Sharpie, so that way I have a kind of an outline where I'm going to be cutting. Then we're going to take it to, well, at least I'm going to take it to the bandsaw, and we're going to go ahead and cut this thing on the outside of the perimeter. You want to take it very slow and gentle. You go too quick, too fast, and here I have a very fine blade because it's better for cutting. You get a smoother cut. You don't risk the chance of actually fracturing or splitting. Here I'm using a polycarbon. No, actually, this is a plexiglass. I stand correct. I chose this because it was on the shelf, sitting around collecting dust. But take your time, go slow, and use a fine blade, as I said before. If you use something that's too coarse or too much of a bite of a blade, you can risk fracturing and cracking this plexiglass. Here I'm going to go ahead and fire up this sand, this belt sander, and we're going to take it one step at a time, rotating the disc or the piece we just cut out and sanding off the edges and getting it within the perimeters of where the line is that I drew. This is a 6-inch or just slightly smaller than 6-inch. We will sand it until it's nice and round, smoothed out, and within the perimeters that will seat down inside the 4-inch to 6-inch coupler, they call it. I had to go back and look at my notes. It's specific details help. If you call it a jointer or any other name when you're looking for these parts, sometimes these people at the plumbing places or when you're looking for the resources give you the deer in the headlight look. Again, this is what I'm using on hand that I had laying around. Take your time, go a little bit round, pick it up, put it back down after adjusting for rotation, and sand it right up to the black line that you made. Here I want to make sure it sits down in and seats properly, not too high, not too low into the coupler. See? Now I'm going to go ahead and drill the holes going on the outside of the perimeter a little bit at a time and work my way to the middle. These are 1/8-inch drill holes. 1/8 drill bit is what you're going to need. And just take your time. Do it on a piece of plywood or a piece of wood so you don't have the fracturing or splintering. Now that we've got multiple holes and we got it looking much like a shower head, that's what you're looking for. At this point, we're going to insert it in here, make sure it's all cleaned off, and we're going to use a glue adhesive, which is a medium-bodied. Keep in mind, we use a medium-bodied clear number 16 solvent type cement to to adhere the cut piece inside this diffuser housing, which we are using a coupler that goes from 4-inch to 6-inch. Here we're going to mount this on top and making sure it's just seated. We're not gluing this part because we need to be able to have access to go back to this in the future if we need to clean service or do some maintenance on the sand filter. For that reason, we will check and make sure that we are able to just pull this thing right off with a slight twist and you do whatever we need to do, service, clean out, or repack and redo again. See? So this is the final example of what it looks like. I fastened the whole unit to a piece of PVC and everything down to a board, which is a 2-foot square piece of plywood, 1/2 inch or 3/4. This is an example of what it will look and do. Of course, we'd have a separate container that's clean for catching the clean water coming out of the filter. I'm just using this as an example to demonstrate what you're looking at, the finished result, and in this case, depending on how fine the sand, depends on how much flow is going to happen through there. If you can use a wider container, wider than 4-inch, you'd be much better off if you can use a wider container than 4-inch, like a barrel or a container. But this is just something to show the concept. Again, this is the materials list that I used, that I had most of it laying around around the house to do this demonstration with. And again, I will have this website posted under description on this video where you can find this PDF and download it to get the details and go through the different pages here, details, specifics, and help guide you. This is my example of what I followed. And here I'm going to recommend and suggest a few globalize this. I'll have these links posted under video description. Are good videos to check out talking about the sand filter, the pros and cons, how it works, little bit of specifics, short, sweet, to the point, and there's a whole lot of them. I would suggest check out my playlist under How a Sand Filter Works playlist. Samaritan's Purse, I will have that link. It's up here in the top left. I'll have that link posted under description as well. They really go into a nice illustration here, and I would suggest it. They work with third world countries and at real life application, and how they construct theirs out of concrete using sheet metal and specifics. Here they go into a illustration on how the sand filter goes and works. There's a multiple processes and four steps that they go into specifics about. Good to listen to. Here they do a specific illustration on how they construct their concrete base sand filter step by step in a nutshell. And again, I will come up here to the top and I'll put that link under video description, because they actually show you how to, and this is actually the concept, or this is what they're doing from the PDF. The PDF actually does this method, and this is what Samaritan Purse Foundation is doing. This is different than the one that I did, but this actually follows the PDF step by step.